All right, so we are live right now.
Sumimasen.
So by the way, if you guys can hear us, right? We're gonna start in a while. If you can hear us, you can see us clearly, you know, please introduce yourself, you know, say hi, let us know where you're from. Meanwhile, I am going to just broadcast this to a few different groups, and just give me a moment.
I'm just going to your profile to see if you can, if I can see it clearly.
Yep. Let me just, one minute. Let us know where you guys tuning in from, which country, so on and so forth.
Yeah, I'm getting it. It's coming in.
All right, it's coming in. And now, hold on a minute. Okay, let me share this with a few groups. Share group. Let me see, share it. Circle. Right, if you guys can hear us, please comment, say hi. You know, hopefully it's not too lagging, you know.
We're having some internet issues here today. I'm not sure if it's your internet or mine. I mean, I got this super powered pocket Wi-Fi that's really, really fast, but to be honest, I just did a speed test. It's a little slower than normal.
I'm using LAN cable. Mine is 700 over Mbps, so...
Yeah, should be okay.
Mine should be fine.
Yeah, and normally mine is fine. I think it's just weird. I don't know. I can't explain it. So, guys, it's 9 p.m. here in Japan, and I'm sorry. I'm having a couple beers and enjoying some gyoza while I do this. But I'm going to drop some serious value bombs, so that's that, you know. Hope you guys enjoy it.
Yeah, hold on. Give me 1 second. Let me just broadcast this to a few groups. We have Edmund here. What's up? We have Eddie. Eddie is Senji Kakashi. With Wilfred, Samantha. Hello, everybody. Share this to a page. Chris is enjoying some gyoza. And oh, nice. Make me hungry.
It's really good.
Okay. And one last one. All right, please be patient with me. We have Ng Po Ling. Hello. Right, last one here. Okay. All right, let me go back to Be Live and make sure I'm there. Okay. So, what's up, everyone? So, today we're going to go. Oh, Chris is still mouthful. But let me do the quick introduction here, right? Yeah. Quick introduction here. This video is to share, right? About in specific, so Chris, so I'm gonna go straight forward, right? Nothing to hide. On 25th August next month, Chris and I will be organizing another private mastermind, and this time it's two full days, right? Two full days jam-packed with, you know, all the blueprints, the strategies and everything. We cover as much as we can from, you know, product research, from building seven-figure stores, the blueprint, from you know, Facebook ads and everything else, you know, CBO and a lot of other stuff, right? Print on demand, drop shipping and all. So we're doing this Facebook Live to show you that, hey, it's possible, you know, with one good design, one good product, it's possible for you to generate, you know, as much as over $500,000 in sales.
To be honest, even more.
Yeah. Even
I've had
more,
students exactly. I've had students do in the millions. So it's there totally possible.
Mm. Exactly. So if you have questions, anything at all about e-commerce, about our event, right, just comment below this video and we'll answer every question that we can, right? So without further ado, you know, probably let me just start the ball rolling, right? Mm-hmm. So I mean, Chris, everyone was like, you know, they're so excited and they're like, wow, you know, one product, $500,000 in sales. I'm sure, right? They have a lot of questions, like, what product is it? How, who, when, why, and 1,000 question marks. Maybe can you share one tip, like, you know, I don't know, man. Any good tip that you have?
So I've got two things in mind here tonight. Number one is to get you excited about the idea of joining our mastermind. Mm-hmm. The reason why we changed it to 2 days, one, is anyone who was there knows that it was power-packed full of information, but I was literally, especially towards the end, racing as fast as possible to get through some information because I wanted to make sure everyone walked out with enough information to go out and get started, right, with our e-com store. So that experience, John, I realized that we truly need 2 days to deliver it right. Okay. So anyway, for people who are on this call, one of the biggest things that I think the biggest mistake people are making, and I say this with such hesitation because actually one of my very best friends in this industry who's been one of my biggest supporters is actually a maker and producer of one of these spy softwares out there in the marketplace. You know, the spy software, you can spy on, you know, what products on other people's stores are getting the most traffic, right? And you can assume if that product's getting the most traffic, it's probably getting the most sales, right? There's no way you can know the total number of sales because Shopify's API knows data is closed off. Right? You can't see that data. But you can extrapolate, right? You know that a typical Shopify store converts between 1% to 7 or 8%, right? And the average is 1.5, but a good store will be converting around 3 or 4%. So you could say through some analytics through through the steps, you can get a general idea of the amount of traffic in a given time, like in a recent time, not the old time, but like sort of in the past week or two that a certain product's getting, right? And so you can extrapolate, okay, they're probably doing this much sales. But anyway, so using these software apps has turned into the enemy for 99.99% of the Shopify sellers. And that may sound kind of weird because you're saying to yourself, well, Chris, wait a minute. I can go out and use one of these Shopify apps and find out what the best sellers are, or I could go to AliExpress and list my best sellers and find what the best are. Why shouldn't I be chasing those? Well, because every other asshole in the marketplace is doing it. So the first few people who jump on a certain product and are ahead of the curve, they make a killing. Mm-hmm. But the rest of the people, you're like the sheep following the lamb herder to the slaughterhouse. Because everyone's advertising the same stuff. Everyone. And especially in dropshipping. This is one of the reasons why I don't like dropshipping. It's so easy to go out and copy other people. It's so easy. With print-on-demand, right, you got to come with your own unique design. You even got to have access to the right supplier. I'm currently selling something on my website that literally my competition is reaching out to me and saying, Chris, where are you getting that? They literally want to know. Where are you getting that? Because I can't find it. Right, so you know it's to be a big winner. Okay, now, and I just dropped a big hint in the beginning. Right, I said the first 2 to 3 or 4 stores to jump on that make a killing. Right, the new trending product on AliExpress. Right, what does that say? The first 3 to 4 stores that do that are unique. They're unique. So instead of doing what I call winner chasing, which is what everyone else is doing, which is going out and just trying to figure out what else everyone else is selling. Oh, I'll sell that too. If everyone's zigging, you should be zagging. If everyone's going this way, you should be running the opposite way, trying to come up with something unique idea. And this is infinitely harder, okay?
It is.
How can you, okay, come from a place saying, okay, well, how do I know what to sell if I don't model what other people are selling and I try to come up with my own unique ideas? You become, and you've heard me talk about this a lot. How long have you heard me talk about the idea of becoming the market master? How many years ago? A million times. And how long have I been talking about it? How many years have I been talking about it?
I don't know, man. Many, many years, really.
Yeah, many years. Become the market master. Okay. And what I mean by that is you should know your market and your customers better than you know your girlfriend, boyfriend, husband, wife, child, whatever, right? You should truly research it. It's astonishing to me how many small business owners can't, if you're on this live stream right now, I'm going to ask you a question. And You don't have to answer, okay? And you're going to think I'm an asshole for asking this. And you may not like it, but I'm doing you a big favor. How many of you do not even know your top three main competitor stores in your niche that are selling big on Facebook?
Mm-hmm.
Right now we have about, I don't know how many people on this call, but I can guarantee you 95% of you cannot name them. Let me ask you a question. You're the business owner. Now imagine you worked for Amazon, just Amazon, right? Or Ford Motors, one of these big Ford, and you're a general manager. If the president walked up to you and said, who is our number one three competitors, and you couldn't name them, you know what would happen to you?
Get fired.
You'd be fired in a heartbeat. I mean, you'd be out the fucking door so fast, you'd even know it hit you. And yet, us small business owners are out here running Shopify stores, and we can't even know our competition is, let alone what they're selling, what they're posting on their fan pages. So I just, guys, what I just told you, man, if you out and go out and research and truly get to know your niche, then you have more knowledge, right? And then you understand it. Then you can start to come up with unique ideas of stuff that we are ahead of the curve. You want to be leading the curve. You don't want to be following the curve.
There you go, right? I think the biggest tip here is you want to be unique. And that's, print on demand, definitely. Even with dropshipping AliExpress, be unique, right? You know, don't just copycat and, you know, just follow other people. I mean, those softwares are good, but I think, you know, it helps you to just do research to understand your niche better so that you become the master of your niche.
You know? Absolutely. I'm not saying use a software. In fact, in my course in Mastermind, I actually introduce my friend's software. But I emphasize to my people in that course, this is not a copying tool. This is just merely a research tool to understand your niche, where most people are using it as a copying tool.
Yep. I've seen that. You know, I mean, like one trending product, and like if you search in Facebook, it's like, holy crap, like there are like, I don't know, man, 20, 30 videos, the exact same videos that they use. People keep recycling. And it's crazy, right? I mean, so anyway, we have Tony from Vietnam, John Ko, Dylan Jong. Welcome. For those of you watching, if you have any questions at all about e-commerce, you know, summer, Q4, anything at all, just ask. Chris and I are here to answer your questions. Okay. If anything to add on,
Chris? Yeah. I do. And I want to... First of all, I want you guys to ask questions. I'm willing to stay on this thing for a long time, but I want you to drive with questions because I want to answer your questions. I want to help you. But let's talk about summer. Okay. Right now, summer is the hardest season to make sales through paid ads. Mm-hmm. Over the next 2 months, you're gonna see 100 million posts in the Shopify groups on Facebook saying, oh, Facebook's dead. I can't make sales anymore. It's dead. Oh, God. Oh. I've been in this game since 2012, and I think you can hear the sarcasm in my voice. Every single year, 2012, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, and now 19.
19.
Facebook doesn't work anymore. It's dead. The product I was selling in this spring is not selling anymore, right? The product doesn't. And by the way, it's not a reflection of the fact that your product is not good, okay? Before I give you the solution, let's take a step back and understand where your customers are coming from. 1% of the world, the United States, 1% own 79% of the wealth in the United States. 1%. It's important for you to understand because that means that 99% of the people in the United States are sharing 19% of the wealth.
Mm-hmm.
Okay? So that doesn't mean that they're poor. There are a lot of poor people in America, but that means that they are living paycheck to paycheck. And every single paycheck, they have money that goes to rent, money that goes to savings and retirement for the future. right? Because they're not a business owner. They couldn't suddenly make a lot of money. They got to save little by little, month after month. Month after month is really important, right? They got money that goes to food, money that goes to... So they have this much money in their budget for what I call, you know, fun spending. Whether that be going out drinking, right? Going out to eat out, right? Instead of eating at home. Whether that be to buy your necklace you're selling on your website, the t-shirt you're selling, right? Okay, so, and in the spring, they're willing to spend that money. In the fall, they're willing to spend that money. And right, because they're really willing to do so, right? But in summer, you know what they're thinking? My kid wants to go to Disneyland. We're taking a vacation and we're taking a drive to Palm Springs. I've got to save every extra penny I have for that summer vacation that's coming. And I know this for a fact because I've actually talked to customers on my website who say, I can't buy that now. I'd love to have that, but I'm saving for the summer vacation. I'll buy it in the fall when I get more money. Okay? So if you think that you can just sell anything to people in summer that you've been selling year-round, you're wrong. It just won't work. The hot products in the spring, fall, and the winter will not sell well in the summer. And if you think that discounting will work, right, from a guy who's tried, and some of my friends tried discounting, taking that product that you were selling in the fall and just doing a massive discount, that doesn't work. Because no one's going to be motivated by $10 off or $20 off, whatever it is, or free shipping, to buy something they don't need right now that they can buy later, when it's the difference between them saving for that vacation they're going to do in August with their family. America's 90% of families take some sort of vacation, even if it's like a short 1 or 2 day vacation. And it takes every single one of their extra bit of money to pay for that. Okay? So that means it's not Facebook that's failing to deliver sales. The customers are not in a big buying mood. But I've had students, and we've also done well in the summer. But the question is how? And is only one solution from a guy who's been in this industry for a long time. And that is summer-specific products. Things they have, shit they have to use now. Let me give you an example. Last year, our big seller was flip-flops.
Yep.
Huge. People wear flip-flops to the beach when they go out on vacations, right? They wear flip-flops for, you know, around town because it's hot, right? Think about your niche. What is it that I can offer them now that's cool, but they have to use it now? Come late September when it gets cold or whatever, summer's over, they're not going to need this anymore for another 6 or 8 months. That's the product you want. And if you could sell that, and it's got a great design or a great feature or some summer problem, if you're in the AliExpress dropshipping point of view, excuse me, then you could turn that from a want to a need.
That's so true.
You got to be thinking about summer stuff. That's the key. It's the only way you understand, or you can overcome the summer lag.
There you go.
You can go out and make $1 million with what I just told you today on this live stream.
Yeah, I mean, flip-flops is huge. It's huge. I've seen some that's my competitors selling well in my niche, flip-flops. I was like, damn it.
So I mean, it doesn't have to be flip-flops. I was just giving you an example. But I'm just trying to tell you the lines to think. Sunglasses, caps, right? Blocks of sun, right? Specialty sunblock. I mean, maybe there's some, maybe if you're a vegetarian, maybe, I don't know. You could find some, you know, doesn't use any animal sunblock, animal products, sunblocks. The vegetarians and the vegans will love that. And they need the sunblock anyway. I'm literally just throwing these ideas. I have no idea if sunscreen uses animal products or if there's even a non-animal product. I just made that up literally off the top of my head. But I'm trying to get you to think outside. Think summer. Just, you got to think, okay, how can I come up with something for my niche that they have to use right now? And if you can do that, and you can come up with something that they want, you can make a lot of money in the summer. Despite, you can overcome, you're going to overcome, you know, Mary in Colorado subjection that said, oh, I need this $40 for my trip, my summer trip. Oh, yeah, oh, I need that. Oh, yeah, that if I don't buy it now, I'm not going to be able to use it. Oh, that's a really cool design. I like that. Oh, okay, I'll take it. You overcome that. Does that make sense?
Yeah, and
a lot of what I'm talking about in this thing is getting into the mentality of your customer. Getting into their wavelength. I'm willing to bet that this is a lot different than what you guys have been hearing in the marketplace. Which is why my students have long-term success. They're not one-term, I call them one-hit wonders. All these guys out there who just have one successful product and they think that they're God's gift to e-com. Sorry to be sarcastic.
So guys, John says spot on. Yeah, yeah. So I hope you guys understand this, right? If you don't understand, ask us, because what Chris just shared is very, very important. And I truly agree, because it's a lot of this is what we're doing as well. And I've seen many people selling summer related products. Some insane stuff. I've seen one, right? Can't remember what's the statistics, but I think it has about 500 over 1,000 shares, like some crazy numbers. It's a specific product.
And you can
product.
Guarantee yeah. that they're making sales on that.
Definitely, definitely. You know, a few hundred thousand shares, I can't remember, it's crazy. And people are loving it because it really solves a problem, in summer, right? So, so it can be some cool products, print-on-demand stuff, or it can be anything that solves a problem. I think that would be very a powerful angle as well, because during summer, there's always people whether they do barbecue stuff or summer is always hot, you can find something to solve this. I'm not going to reveal the exact product, but hey, you can find something to solve this problem, then people will pay you money for it, right?
They're absolutely will. I'm going to repeat the statement I just made, but this is really important. They don't have extra money to spend because they're going to save that money for their summer activities, right? Vacations or short-term activities. The only way you overcome that is by offering them something that they need right now that they can only use now.
There you go. I totally agree, man. I've seen comments like they're like, I'm gonna buy this later when I get my salary, or when I get this and all. Totally can relate to what you just mentioned.
Or I've literally seen comments in July and August. Oh, I'm gonna wait till fall. Okay, and by the time fall rolls around, they forgot about that product because it's so long, right? So
that's true. That's true. All right, so let's talk about let me see what else we have. And so I shared another screenshot about the students' results, right? Some doing over $600 over $1,000 in 30 days. Some of there's a lot of them, many of them doing 150K a month, 160K a month, 50,000 in 10 days, and so on and so forth, right? So obviously, number one, become the master in your niche. What else? Any other tips that you can you share with them? How can I attend this? People watching here, if they're interested, they're like, hey, I also want to get these results. Chris, help me.
Okay. Well, there's a couple of things you can. Number one, you want to master one traffic source, right? And I think Facebook's a great way to go, but there's other traffic sources. So get really good at one traffic source and learn how to scale it, okay? You also want to think about the back end, right? This is something that a lot of people don't focus on, but the first transaction should not be the last transaction.
That's true.
I mean, think about this. What's the most expensive thing you can do in your business? that's acquire a customer for the first time. Okay. And so this is one of the reasons why actually I'm not a big fan of dropshipping is because what regardless of whether the product is good or bad or whatever, when someone waits in this modern day of internet business in e-commerce, 3 to 4 weeks to get their product in China, they're not going to be buying from you again. You could have sent them a gold, right? The bonus was a piece of gold. Okay, maybe it's a piece of gold. They might buy again. But you're going to go broke very soon if you're sending people gold. But anyway, okay. Of course, there's always a small amount
of people will buy. Gifts, yeah.
What, sorry?
Free gifts, you know. The China free supply gift. Is like they're throwing some free gifts.
Yeah. I mean, there will always be a few people who buy, but the repeat customer rate will be low, okay? So, which is why I think you need to think about it. Even if you're dropshipping in China, there's ways you can speed up your shipping times. There's ways you can make sure you're working with good suppliers, right? With POD, there's not really going to have that problem because all the POD stuff are emphasized speed of delivery. But so that experience, how their product shows up, you know, whether it's good-looking packaging, right? Packaging, guys, is actually really important. I mean, when a box shows up, I mean, okay, for example, you guys, you know, I have this one for Japan, right? But I also have a global one called Skyrome. And Skyrome showed up in this incredible, I don't use Skyrome in Japan because this is so much better, but when I was in Japan, I use it all the time when I travel. Skyrome showed up in this incredible cardboard box that was so well made and expensive. And I actually kept the box. I don't know why. It just felt like a shame to throw it away. I didn't even use it. I still have it. Had that box sitting on my desk for like almost 2 years. Okay. Wow. So the packaging makes a difference. So again, when you're dealing with a lot of shop, Ali. So when you're working with a lot of different suppliers, random suppliers from AliExpress, they're packaged in all sorts of strange ways. It doesn't look presentable. So when you work with a POD supplier, and that's part of the whole process of POD. But if you're going to be doing jobs in China, that's fine. But you got to try to limit the number of suppliers you're working with, and then reach out to suppliers and talk to them. Say, well, how much extra is going to cost me to get it put it into a good-looking packaging? Right, so it looks and shows up, and when it shows up, it's presentable. So try to negotiate faster shipping with them, and you can at a reasonable price. Try to negotiate better packaging. Right, try to make sure that you're getting a good customer experience. Tracking on your website, right, this all creates an overall image where people are going to want to go back and buy from you. A nice follow-up email series, right, with things like, you know, order confirmation, you know. Even an upsell offer, but people don't mind being sold to if they had a good experience or they're having a good experience. We upsell offer 30 minutes after they buy from our site. I shit you not. There's an email that goes out 30 minutes after they buy from you. Hey, thank you for buying again, and here's another offer.
Yeah.
And people take it. 20% of the people take that upsell. It's amazing.
Nice.
Okay, so then, and then we send them an email. We have where we say, you know, your order's been delivered. You know, how'd you like it? And review, and then we upsell them again, right? So this whole process, right? The whole back end process. There's so many things you can do. When someone goes buys from our website, we hit them on with an ad on Facebook saying thank you for your purchase. We're using the dynamic product retargeting ads to thank people for buying from us after they purchased.
Yeah, normally we use it just to retarget and, you know, ask them to buy, or no, you didn't, you know, you add to cart, you didn't purchase and all. But now using DPA to thank them, I think that's cool.
Because DPA says DPA allows you to have post-purchase ads we will buy from you. And in our post-purchase ad, we don't even sell them. It's literally just thank you for your purchase.
That's nice.
And people actually message the fan page saying thank you. I appreciated getting that thank you message.
Yeah, it's at the end of the day, it's about customer experience, really. You know,
it is. And but so many people in our industry are so focused on the short term, making money, they're missing the fact that if you're so focused on that, you're going to lose a lot of money on the back.
That's true. That's true. I mean, there are many ways to do drop shipping. You know, one of my new favorite way, it's you know, drop shipping from Etsy. So the store owners are from United States. So shipping is fast, packaging is beautiful, and like we ship to customers within 3 to 5 days. You know, packaging is superb, and so that's one of the, you know, one of the reason why I love to drop ship from Etsy. You know, and the owners are all, you know, people from United States. So, I mean, like you said, you know, drop shipping AliExpress China, there's always some ways to go about, you know, especially for winning products. You know, you can buy in bulk, send a warehouse, fulfillment center, nicer packaging, so on and so forth. So,
I think dropshipping Etsy is a great idea. The only downside of dropshipping Etsy is you run into two potential issues. I've dropshipped from Etsy in the past, in 2015. Mm-hmm. Of course, pricing is more expensive, but we literally ran out of supply quite quickly. Yeah. Most sellers on Etsy are not used to doing huge numbers.
Yeah, that's true. That's very true. That's very true.
By the way, just when I say huge numbers, I'm talking like 20,000, 30,000 orders, or even a few thousand orders.
Yeah. And what's the one thing? So, yeah, so I totally agree with you, right? We do face a few of our winning products the same problem. So one of our solutions is, again, go back to China, manufacturing in masses there. But anyway, so the take-home message, I think, here is, you know, back-end, right? Whether it's email marketing, I mean, email marketing is huge, right? So we are, you know, in our two-day mastermind, we are going to cover about back-end as well, right, Chris?
That's right. I will get, well, I didn't have an opportunity the first day of the first mastermind to do that because it was, literally, I mean, it was so cramped packed that I had three different ideas I wanted to cover for the product development creation. I only covered one of them. and I blitzkrieged, I mean, ran a sprint to the Facebook ads section. Just, I wanted to get in, my goal was to get enough information in people's hands that they could walk away from the mastermind and start an e-com store. Like the next day or two, right? So to do that, the last important part is traffic, right? So I was, you saw how fast I was writing and talking, yeah. And then like, get that. So what we're going to do this time, next time is 2 days. So it's going to be, we're going to go a lot more detail into product development creation. I'm going to cover all the three key components that, three ways that absolutely are so powerful. We'll go over the Facebook ads again, but this time we'll do it right. More slowly, and assuming that we can get all that done, the last concept I want to talk about is some of the back end ideas to create a high lifetime value of a customer. I can't 100% guarantee that because it depends on how the process of the event goes. But my goal is to get some of those ideas out there, you know, at the event and talk about that as the final component of the event.
Right. So for those who just tune in, right? Quick update, 24th, 25th August, which is next month, right? We're going to have a special 2-day private mastermind. And so, you know, I've put the links in the description, all right? You can click on the link, check out the event. And we have, basically, we have two types of tickets, right? The general admission and the VIP ticket. I mean, honestly, if you ask me, I will, you know, highly suggest you to get a VIP ticket because there's just so much add-on value over there, you know. And I think one of the highlight of the day will be the event, will be the VIP hangout and dinner with both of us, right?
Yes, exactly.
Basically, you know, our goal in this 2-day event, so, if you're in Asia especially, whether it's Malaysia, Singapore, Thailand, Vietnam, wherever you are in Asia, or even if you're in US or wherever you are, and, you know, feel free to join us, right? In my past events, I have people from Australia, you know, and Singapore and a few other countries, and they flew over to Kuala Lumpur to attend our mastermind, right? So
it doesn't matter where you are. We had people from Singapore last time.
Yeah.
Which is close, but I mean, last time it was short notice. Literally 10 days. We started selling 10 days before the event, in the middle of a Muslim holiday.
Yeah.
That was so well planned. Yeah. I'm being sarcastic. We decided to let the last minute to do this. So, but this next one was going to be bigger, badder than ever. And one thing I will say to anyone who buys the VIP ticket, guys, I like drinking beers and hanging out. So as long as the beer is flowing and you want to, we can hang out together, talk e-com until the wee hours of the morning. I've already cleared up my Monday, the following Monday, in anticipation we'll be out late that night.
There you go. I mean, Chris charges like, you know, $5,000, $10,000 and even more for his private one-on-one coaching, right? And so, you know, people pay Chris a lot of money for coaching, but I mean, look at the results that he has helped his students to generate. And these are not the best ones. They have even crazier ones, you know, doing multiple seven figures, even eight figures.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't like to show some of the crazy ones because I want to keep it real. I mean, there's a couple guys who have done, two in particular who have done, let's just say they're millionaires many times over.
There you go.
But I mean, but I have to say, and my lawyer actually requires me to say, that is not the norm, and I cannot promise or you should not expect that. But if you're highly driven and you retain information and you implement it well, you know, the sky is really the limit.
That's true. I mean, once you're equipped with the right knowledge, you know, the blueprint, the system, the strategy, then it's a matter of time, you know, before your results get bigger and bigger. And there you go. You get results in the screenshots that I shared, you know. I believe everyone starts from zero, you know. So, you know, it's hard. It's putting in effort, hard work, learning whatever you need to learn, whether it's Facebook ads or marketing or market research, product research. So, you know, if you're watching this, right, and you're like, you know, I'm all in, right? I really want to build a successful e-commerce business. I really want to build a successful online business, you know. I want to be like Chris, you know. And then, you know, we want to invite you to join our private event. You know, we could have charged, you know, $2,000, $3,000 per person, honestly. I mean, in my past events, I charged as high as $3,000, $5,000, $10,000 per person. But, you know, this time, you know, we want to lower the entry barrier. Our goal is to help as many people as we can, really.
Yeah, in fact, I'm the one who's pushing for the lower prices. I want to have a full house and have an exciting event and you know, help as many people as possible because I think that this is something that, look at me. I mean, who am I, right? I'm this American living in Japan and I'm, you know, am I dressed very fancily? No, and I don't even want to dress fancily. Could I go out and buy an MRA suit tomorrow? Yes, absolutely. I'm just a normal person who likes to drink beer and hang out, right? And I've had success with this since 2012. If I can do it, any of you watching this video absolutely can. You absolutely can. Because I'm nothing special. So, I mean, I wanted to open up and I wanted this to be available to anyone. So that's why, you know, we're making this totally reasonably priced. It's going to be two full days, and we're looking forward to seeing you there and hanging out.
There you go. I mean, think about it, right? For the general ticket admission, right? First 10 people, only $297. I mean,
We already have a couple of those sold already.
Yeah, we have.
So literally, the other eight will be gone soon. That I can guarantee. And then goes up to $497, right?
Yep, it goes up all the way, $397 and $497.
That's right. And then it's what, $997 for the VIP?
Yep, $997 VIP. I mean, think about it, right? You will, here's the truth, you will spend that money eventually, whether it's buying food, whether it's buying clothes, you know, vacation, online courses, you know, programs, anything at all, right? But the experience they're going to have in our event, the knowledge you're going to learn, the strategies, the system, is not available anywhere else. unless you pay Chris, you know, $10,000 to get access to his one-on-one coaching. So, but you know, for this investment, this is a small investment, 2 full days with us, I can guarantee you, your mind's gonna be blown away. When you go back, you'll be like, wow, you know, what I've heard, what I've learned in through YouTube videos and all this stuff, all those are actually crap. Some of them, I won't say all, but some of them.
I want to talk about YouTube, by the way, because I think there is actually good value on YouTube, and I think there are some things to learn. But one of the biggest problems with YouTube is that it's in tidbits, right? You get a few tidbits here and a few tidbits there, and then you get also different ideas, right? This person says that, this person says nothing. So one of the biggest mistakes people make is that, look, what I teach works. Am I the only one out there in the marketplace that's teaching a system for e-com that works? No. And I never pretend to be, right? Some people like me, some people don't, and that's fine, right? But what's really important is that you find someone to follow, or you know, one or two people to follow who know what they're doing and are passionate about helping others, and they have a system in place to follow. Because if you follow one system and then you follow that system, you follow that system, suddenly you're spinning your wheels and you don't know which direction to go in. It's actually worse. It's more costly than paying a coach or a trainer. It really is, because you're just testing this and dabbling, and it's a really bad way to go. And I've seen guys like that, right? And you know, for years and years and years, they're testing that, testing this, and it's like, dude, pick something and focus on it, you know, and then you will have much better results.
I mean, totally true. I've been through this many years ago, when I was just getting started, you know. Nothing wrong with self-learn. I highly encourage someone to self-learn and be proactive, you know, and be resourceful. But if you want to get fast results, you want to get real proven results, you know, like it or not, you will need to have a mentor and mentors, in fact, you know, throughout your journey, whether it's e-com or CPA, ClickBank, whatever they do, right? Affiliate marketing. So it's really crucial. You need to have mentor or mentors, been there, done that, and who really truly wants to help you. And what you say is really true, right? It will be more costly for you if you try to self-learn and you end up going round and round, you know, and I've been there. I've wasted so much time and money just trying to self-learn, you know, wanting to save money, so to say. But when I look back, it's like, holy crap, I just wasted 6 months, or I've seen people 10 years. I have one student, 10 years. I asked him, like, when he reached out to me and we had a strategy call, and I was like, how long have you been trying to make money online? He was like, 10 years. I was like, holy crap, like 10 years. Like he's still not giving up. I truly respect that. Long story short, he enrolled my coaching program. Within 30 days, he did like $11,000. Like, that was his biggest month ever after 10 years. I think this was a few years ago. So
that's awesome.
So it's like, I mean, all of us, I don't think we want to wait for 10 years or try for 10 years to make something work.
So there's more than just the cost of frustration and lost money out of your pocket. There's also lost opportunity.
Yep.
I mean, what could you have made? But where could you have been?
That's true.
All right, and guys. So we're going to go ahead.
Now, I just want to say that, you know, for those of you, I mean, we all have parents, we all have families and all this. So it's like, you know, they can't wait.
They cannot wait yet.
Yeah.
So where are you going to put the link?
The link is in the description. In fact,
oh, beautiful. I'll put.
Yeah. The link is description. Probably you also answer one or two questions. If you guys have questions,
yep. I do. I have time. Go ahead.
Yeah, this is the time to comment your questions. Anything that you want to know. All right. So the Xia Yixin says, Facebook ads is getting more expensive to advertise. What is your take on this?
Bullshit. Complete and utter total crap, bullshit, and wrong. Sorry. Facebook ads are not getting expensive. In fact, Facebook ads are getting cheap. I'm talking about guys. I was on a phone conversation with someone today who's got a product that's getting $25 revenue, and he's getting conversions for $2 or $3 per conversion.
What? $3 per K? Insane.
Yeah, per purchase. Okay, so what is happening is that the competition is getting stiffer, and people are getting lazy and not working to find good offers and products that will sell. Facebook's job is not to make you sales. It's to send you traffic.
Mm-hmm.
It's your job to convert that traffic.
Mm-hmm.
So if you're getting expensive conversions, you're not doing your job.
Not doing good enough. Gotta improve. Yeah.
Sorry to be so blunt, but I'm on my third beer now, so...
But I mean, we have to be honest, because if we try to sugarcoat and, you know, say the nice sweet things, we're gonna harm them rather than you know, do them more good. Another question, Timothy.
I tell you for a fact, if you got a good offer and a good product or whatever, even if I'm trying to say offer, because this applies to lead generation or CPA or whatever, if your offer, whatever you're selling, is good, Facebook ads can be cheap.
Yep. That's true. Another question by Timothy. What is the best CBO strategy that you are using?
I've actually proactively decided, because CBO is the future, I don't talk about CBO at all, except for within my group course and mastermind.
All right.
That's it.
So stay tuned, Timothy, or you can join our 2-day mastermind, and you can ask Chris face to face. You know, I'm sure he will share some.
If you're at the event, I will talk about it, because people have paid to be at the event. So, but yes, CBO is working, but I'm not talking about any strategies related to CBO openly, publicly, except for non-paying students.
All right, so Timothy, I hope.
Except for two paying students. Sorry, paying students.
Yeah, so Timothy, I hope you join our mastermind. You know, I mean, just click on the link, check out the website. Everything is there. I'm not here to hard sell you, but you know, we guarantee that this will be an awesome experience for you. I mean, I've been in the industry for many years, and in Malaysia, you know, there's hardly such event. You know, I mean, I've attended many events myself. We have also hosted many events, and I'll say we are one of the few ones in Malaysia that have that organized this kind of event at this such high level. Chris is, in case you guys still don't know that, he's very humble, but you know, I mean, I got to brag a little bit about your results. You know, Chris has done multiple millions for the past many years, and most importantly, you know, as a mentor, as a coach, he is a heart to help many of his students and clients to also generate multiple 7-8 figures, with a disclaimer, of course, from his lawyer that, you know, these results are not typical.
I've been advised strongly by my lawyer that I have to always say that I cannot guarantee any results. I can only teach you what has worked for us in the past.
Yeah. I mean, results are not typical, but I think the reason why, you know, the screenshots and all, those are real screenshots, real results from students. And the reason why we show that is not to brag, it's not to, you know, just show off and all, but to hopefully inspire upon you that, you know, if someone else can do it, you know, from all walks of life, all ages, right? If you're watching this, we want you to know that you can do it too. It's a matter of time, right? And also, of course, you need to equip yourself with the right knowledge. Okay, we got one more question. Do you advise high ticket products for beginners?
I don't have an answer for that because I think it largely depends on your niche. I mean, I've seen a lot of niches where high ticket products are resonate and you should go for that right from the beginning. There are many niches that aren't high ticket, right? I mean, I personally am involved in two businesses right now. One of them we're selling only high ticket stuff. And then my other one, you know, the site I talk about, that's more open about the other one, is the beer niche. It's all low end stuff. I mean, we don't sell anything over $50 in that site. We have a few things on the site that are over $50, but we don't advertise them, right? Because they don't convert. That niche is very cheap. So, I mean, there's no straight answer. You've got to get to know your niche.
All right.
And so by the way, there's no reason why a newbie can't sell high-end products. If you've got a cool product that your customers want, they have no idea that, oh, this person just started e-com yesterday. The customer doesn't know that. So don't sell yourself short. If you are in a niche that you think high-end products will sell, by all means, from day one, charge $2,000.
Yeah, I mean, of course, you know, hopefully the products, you know, help people solve problems and all this kind of stuff, then people will pay you money for it, right? So Wilfred, hopefully answer your questions. Are there any last questions? If you have, just post it in comments. Chris, any last words of wisdom about our, you know, private events or anything at all?
I think the more important thing is, and I actually want to send a message. In the last minute, I don't want to sell the event. I mean, I hope you come. I think you're crazy not to. But I want you guys to believe it's possible, okay? And I want to leave you with one thing that's really important, right? And I actually say this on a lot of my private coaching calls, especially when people are feeling down it's not going well. When it comes to the short-term goal of making money, I'm stepping away from the big picture, which is I talked about a lot about today about, you know, building a long-term business, and I believe that's where you should be headed. But I understand and get that people sometimes just need cash now, right? Mm-hmm. This is Japanese yen. Because I'm in Japan, but you need, you know, something like this now, right? And I get that, right? Well, when it comes to that, here's the reality. And this may shock a lot of you, but you're one product away.
Right.
You could have launched 100 products, 200 products, 300, 400, 500, 1,000 products. At the end of the day, you are one winning product away from making money.
Very true.
It's so true. I've seen people, especially dropshippers, and they don't have a long-term sustainable business model, so it doesn't last a long time, but I've seen guys make $30,000 profit, $50,000, even $1 million profit on one product in a very short, sustained a short period of time. So I'm not talking about a sustainable business model, which is what I think you should be focused on long term. But hey, there are times that, hey, you're desperate for money, and I understand, and I get that too. And you are literally one product away from that. One product that away so from true. Bringing in that cash that you need.
Very true. Very true. I've been there, done that. I've also seen so many people, you know, achieving this too. And it's crazy. The e-com is a crazy thing. I mean, in a good way.
That's good. So, yeah. I mean, if you're out there frustrated right now, just understand that you are literally, and just keep reminding yourself that, hey, I am just one product away.
Which comes to never give up, right? I mean, if you just give up today, it's the end. But hey, if you keep going, it's okay if you're slow, but as long as you progress, you know. Mm. You never know. Your next product, you know, hit home run.
Could be the one.
That's it.
Yep.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Right. So, having said that, no, we hope, right? You join our 2-day mastermind, and you know we'll share with you the blueprint behind the scenes, the strategies. One more thing we forgot to talk about: Q4, the fourth quarter, Black Friday, Cyber Monday, Christmas.
Here's all I'll say on this. One last thing. I'll say this.
Sure.
Every Q4, new millionaires are made.
New millionaires are made.
They are. Every Q4. And the reason being is on every given website, 50% of sales, sorry, not any given website. I think CPA and it's still different, but any store that's selling any product, like jackets or physical goods, right? 50% of the revenues are generated in Q4. 50%. And that's not just true for us. It's true for any store. Guys, Toys R Us declared bankruptcy last year. Okay?
Yeah.
They're gone. Right? But they actually, in their bankruptcy claim, they were able to allow the stay in operations despite the fact that they filed bankruptcy, I think it was August. I remember this story because I was on a vacation with my girlfriend. And I was like, holy shit, Toys R Us is closing down. And so, but they were allowed to continue operations through the end of the year. Why do you think they were allowed to do that?
Just say a lot of money.
they know that a lot of money is coming, and the liquidators who are going to liquidate Toys R Us, at least in the United States, so it's not in Toys R Us, Toys in the United States, wanted that cash to pay back the creditors. There's owed, so there's owes, right? Think this. What messed us? Instead of shutting it down, Q4, we're gonna let it operate for the next 3 months, right? 4 months. 50% of the revenue is generated in Q4. So guys, there are people who go from broke to millionaire status every year. Now, I'm not saying you're gonna do that. In fact, to be honest, it's difficult. I'm not gonna bullshit you. You're gonna have to work your ass off, and the odds are against you. But even if you don't do that, what if you just do 50,000 profit in Q4? What if you just do 100,000, 200,000? Who'd be happy with that? Who would like to make 100,000 profit in October, November, December?
And oh, man,
by the
yes.
way, that is by the way, okay. All right. I may get shot for saying this, but that is actually a pretty doable goal. 100K in 3 months is quite doable. That time of year. I'm not going to say 100K in 3 months is doable other times of year. That's I mean, unless you get a really good product, everything's lined, the stars are all lined up. For example, in the summer, you got the right summer product, all the stuff that we talked about earlier. That is much harder. But in the fall, in that Q4, 100K in 3 months is quite doable.
And guess what? You know, in our mastermind at the end of August is perfect. Perfect timing. We're going to share with you strategies, you know, probably some product ideas and everything that we can to help you to crush it on Q4, right? It's the perfect timing, you know, end of August, so you have September, October, November, December.
We're talking a lot about Q4, and I'm going to be talking about some Christmas stuff, that Christmas products you can sell. Didn't really mention this on the sales page, but I'm going to reveal, you know what? I'm going to reveal two hot selling Christmas products that sell every year without fail. All you have to do is go out and get your own design for it. I better write that down. There's a bonus I just made up off the top of my head right now. Remind me if I forget. But no, I've got two products that we've sold, or myself and other students have sold every year, product types that will absolutely work.
I like it.
I mean, let me clarify this. I cannot say it absolutely works, because that's not true. You have a very good chance of making it work if you can come up with the right design for your marketplace. But these product types are winners, and I'll reveal them at the event to everyone. This is whether you're VIP or not, it's a bonus.
You're getting this.
You're going to get two winning product ideas handed to you on a silver platter.
Wow.
For Q4.
Amazing. Amazing. This is huge. I mean, think about this. For either, depending on whether which ticket you purchase, even you join a VIP at 997 and you get access to this surprise bonus. And where Chris shared you, they're winning, you know, winning products and all this. And you're going to implement what you learn, you know, through the event. What is 997? I mean, you can, in just a few days, you're going to make even more than $997 in net profit. And I mean, like what Chris mentioned, $100,000 in 3 months, it's very realistic, very doable. So, you know, you got to think, I want you guys to think long term, right? For this is, yes, there is an investment to join our mastermind, but I can guarantee that if you put in the effort, if you, you know, have the right mindset and you put in effort, you're hardworking, you will earn much, much more in return. If you're lazy, then that's too bad. But, you know, we teach what works, right? So you can see all the testimonials, all the results, you know, all those, you know, we can't lie about it. Like, those are true, right? And so Norman said, I want you to teach, mentor me until I understand how to do e-commerce thing, all right? So Norman, hope to see you in a mastermind.
See you at the event, my friend.
Yeah. So I guess there's no more other questions. But if they are, you know, we'll answer that later on. But having said that, probably Chris, when you're in Malaysia, when you're coming to Malaysia soon, right?
July 20th, but I arrived quite late, almost just before midnight on Saturday night.
No worry. I mean, we have, you know, probably we'll do a few more Facebook lives, you know, hopefully we can give more value to you guys for free.
We will.
You know, and, you know, and if you want to scale your e-com business to the next level, or you want to just get started, and learn real proven strategies from real experts, people who have been there, done that, then, you know, we want to invite you, you know, to join our mastermind. It's a very rare event. Chris doesn't come to Malaysia very often, you know, so, you know, we just want to help more people. Hopefully you will be the next success story that we can share with everyone. Click on the link. Should be above, below this video. I'll post it in comments. Tickets are limited, and this is 100% sure it's not scarcity, right? We can't do like Grand Cardon, 10,000 people in the stadium. So tickets are limited. We hope you'll be there. Right, Chris? Any final messages you want to share?
Cheers. Although I'm done.
So there you go, right? So thank you for tuning in. I hope you guys enjoy this Facebook Live. Do share your thoughts and feedback. You know, do you enjoy this? How else do you want to, any other specific topic that you want us to cover or you want us to talk about in the next Facebook Live or any other suggestions, feel free to share with us, okay? So that's it. I'm going to end this broadcast and have a great night, everyone.
Cheers.
Thanks for watching the video. To watch the next one, click right here. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button right here.